Good morning, friends. MG 8591, Principles of Management, 4th year, 7th semester, Introduction 1. Introduction to Management and Organization, Unit Number 1, Topic 7, Organization Culture. So, before going to lesson, we have one problem statement and queries available. You can justify answer and then move on lesson. So problem, Kiran Industry is a company dealing in the office furniture. The company choose to diversify its operation to improve its growth potential and increase market share as the project was important. Many alternatives were generated for the purpose and were thoroughly discussed amongst the members of the organization. After evaluating the various alternatives, Sukhvinder, the managing director of the company, decided that they should add home interior and furnishing as a new line of business activity. So next, go to next. So name of this is a problem. The name of the framework which the diversity organization should adopt to enable it to cope up with emerging complexity. Give one reason in support of your answer. This answer, a divisional structure should be adopted by diversity organization to enable it to be cope up with emerging complexity. A reason, it lead to faster decision making and promote the flexibility and initiative because each division function an autonomous unit. This is organizational culture. So organizational culture is a workplace, value, leadership, people, technology, motivation and tools. So organization culture is defined as a set of belief, value, assumption that are shared by members of an organization. And these underlying values have an influence on the behavior of an organization members as an employee, rely on these values to guide the decision and behavior. So I'm a manager, my work is divided to my subordinate, and subordinate divided to working workers. I believe my subordinate. The subordinate believe in my workers. Those are complete my works and send to my subordinate. The subordinate send to myself and segregate all works into one value and send to my top level management. That is, I believe my subordinates. And value, what is the value of my work and assumption? And whether it is properly working or not, that is the assumption of my work. These are organization culture and belief with my subordinates. Next one. This is a characteristics of dimension of organization culture. So this is based on 7 characteristics are available. One is innovative, aggressive, outcome oriented, stable, and people oriented, and team oriented, and detail oriented. These are 7. Most things, the 7, these are 7 is important one. So that is characteristics of dimension organizational cultures. The next one. So next one, characteristics, definition of each and every characteristics. So first one is innovative culture. So company that have innovative culture are flexible and adaptable and experiment with new ideas. These companies are characteristic by a flat hierarchy in which title and other status distinguish tend to be downplayed. Aggressive cultures. So a company with aggressive culture with value competitiveness and outperforming competitor. By emphasizing this way may fall short area and corporate social responsibility. Example, Microsoft Corporation is often identified a company aggressive cultures. Next one, outcome-oriented cultures. So outcome-oriented cultures is those who emphasize achievement, result, and action as an important value. For example, I start a new company. What is my achievement? What is my result? What is my action? Based on developing a product, based on manufacture-oriented, based on hospitalization-oriented. These are some outcome-based oriented cultures. So next one is a stable culture. Stable cultures are predictable and real, rule oriented and bureaucratic. This organization aims to coordinate and align individual effort for greatest level of efficiency. So stable means predictable oriented. For example, I'm working in rainforest area. So rainforest department. So whether it is rain is coming or not, this is my predictable. So if it is possible, I'm telling about is true. If not, there is no promise, no problem. That is predictable one. That is not other sides. Okay, this is a predictable one and rule oriented and bureaucratic. This is a stable cultures. Next one, this is a people oriented cultures, and the people oriented cultures value fairness, supportiveness, and respect for individual rights. This organization truly live the mantra that people are the greatest asset. This is a people as the greatest asset. That means customer my asset. That is the people oriented cultures. The team oriented cultures, the company with the team oriented cultures are collaborative and emphasis cooperation among the employee. For example, Southwest Airlines company facilitated the team oriented culture by cross training and it employs that they are capable of helping of each others are needed. This is a team oriented process. This is a detail oriented cultures. So this is a detail oriented cultures, a creative idea, think and design. So these are detail oriented. So detail oriented are organization which detail oriented cultures are the characteristics in the OCP. Organization culture profile. The framework has emphasis, precision and paying attention to detail. So such cultures give competitive advantage to company in the hospitality industry by helping them different themselves from others. This is advantage of organization culture. So easy to form and wind up, and direct motivation and quick decision, promote actions, better control and maintain of business secret, close personal relations and provide self-employment. This is one type of advantages. Second, this is a limited capital. This is a disadvantage of organization culture. Limited capital, lack of community, limited size, lack of manageable exercise. This, before going to activity, I will show you one small video. Next one, activity. Next one, activity. This is the organization culture. This is the next one, advantage of organizational culture. So better work environment, enhance the employee productivity and performance, and increase the efficiency of business process and improve organizational agility. This is the disadvantages, employee resistance and failure, and culture changes that miss the target are culture changes, focusing on organizational cultures instead of performance. Next one. This is assessment. List out the advantage of organizational cultures. Identify the disadvantages of organizational cultures. This is my references and thank you.
Let me introduce you to Jim. Hello, Jim. Let's follow Jim as he grows up, follows his dream, creates his own company, and learns a lot about organizational culture. Every human organization creates a unique culture all its own. From a small family business operating in its hometown to a large global corporation spanning cultures and time zones, each organization has a distinct identity. Organizational culture is influenced by beliefs and assumptions. What do we mean by beliefs and assumptions? Beliefs and assumptions come from the things that we hear, observe, and learn. They also come from the things that we try. Some sometimes these things work, sometimes they don't. Then we retake and try again, just like little Jim. Now let's follow Jim to the university. He meets friends and inspires them.
A quick aside, it's important to give you a simple example. We talk about our...
3 cheers for Jim and his friends as they graduate and team up to form an organization of their own. They decide together where they want to go. They create a foundation that everybody can use and recognize. They form teams which align and engage together to succeed in their market. But in order to succeed, organizations need to be able to adapt. Let's watch Jim and his team as they strive for success together. Underneath the surface of an organizational culture, we have assumptions, beliefs, perceptions, thoughts, and feelings. These are taken for granted. We can't see them. Organizational culture is learned. It grows as we gain experience from our work and move on together over time. The lessons from the past shape our work and life strategies for the future and are important enough to pass on to the next generations, not only for their survival, but also for their development, evolution, and success.